our main aim as husband and wife was to nurture the local students, local Singaporeans who haven't seen anything called dance and theater, to teach them to love the arts. So we have instilled this idea, the people who come and train here, they have started satellite companies of Apsaras all over the world, and that has given us a lot of opportunities to work with international artists who come into Singapore, hearing through these people, and we have been able to also perform internationally. We found all these children who learn in this institution, they have this solo debut, and after that, they have no chance to interact with the rest of the audiences. So that was our main idea of creating Apsaras Arts, so that we could invite all these local children who have graduated and who have standards to perform with us collectively with the imported top senior artists. If you ask me what is Apsaras Arts today, it's a loving family with its ups and downs. The greatest challenge is handling these people, not teaching dancing. Because you must know each artist and each dancer is different from each other. And when you put them collectively together, then you must know exactly where to place them to get the best out of those artists. I tell all the students here, never be satisfied and be happy about what you have got. Always be humble, because that is the stepping stone for success.